Hi, my name is Rebecca Berger, and I'm an editorial fellow at the New England Journal of Medicine. We're here today at the New England Journal editorial offices in Boston to share with you some new exciting updates to Resident 360. NEJM Resident 360 is a website that launched in June of last year. If you haven't had a chance to look at it yet, it's a website designed for residents, where we have online live discussions and lots of resources available for residents. The core of the content on Resident 360 is the rotation prep packages. Rotation prep packages are collections of research, reviews, guidelines that will help you prepare for your next rotation. When the site launched in June, it launched with many of the common rotations that internal medicine residents have during their year. However, we continue to add new content and update our old content. What I'd like to share with you today is two new updates. One is a new package on women's health, and the other is an update in critical care. The women's health package has now been live for a few weeks, and it features topics such as contraception, menopause, polycystic ovarian syndrome, fibroids, and management of pregnancy and preconception counseling. These are issues that are commonly faced by internal medicine and family medicine residents, as well as residents really from many other specialties. In each section of this package, you'll find the same template that you'll see in other rotation prep packages, including a fast facts section, which includes a quick overview of the most important things you'll need to know, followed by research articles. In the research section, you'll find randomized controlled trials and other research articles on this topic. You can then look through review articles, both from the New England Journal of Medicine as well as other journals, and guidelines from the top specialty societies on this topic. In women's health, we also have some tabs that include websites that are geared for patients that you might be able to share. So you can click through these different tabs in the women's health section and learn more about all of these different topics. This is a package that might be useful if your residency does have a women's health rotation, but I know a lot of people don't have that. So it might be useful also on your ambulatory or primary care rotation. The other update I wanted to share with you today is in critical care. Critical care is one of the packages that launched when the website launched in June of last year, but we've just included a fresh set of updates. The most important updates are that the Surviving Sepsis campaign guidelines were just updated in the last few months. So we've now updated the package to reflect those new guidelines. So you'll see here in the sepsis and shock section, as well as resuscitation fluids, we've included the new 2016 surviving sepsis recommendations. We've also added some new tables and algorithms within the package, such as under the ventilation section, management on how to wean a patient from a ventilator. So take a look at these new updates. If you see anything that we're missing, like a great research paper or a review article, or if you see anything that needs to be updated or revised, we'd love to hear from you. You can contact us through the website.